We put billions and billions of tons of CO2 into the atmosphere every year. We should be focusing on reducing those emissions as much as possible. We also need to think about, how do we get that carbon out of the atmosphere? How do we actually capture it?
10 years ago, capturing CO2 from the air, or as it's burned, seemed like a long shot. But today, it's gaining ground, and that's because
it is essential to controlling climate change.
Burning fossil fuels releases large amounts of carbon dioxide, and once it's in the atmosphere, it's really hard to get it out.
It can actually take hundreds of years before carbon will fully leave the atmosphere. We're still experiencing some of the warming that would have been caused by those first tons of, say, coal or oil that were burned for electricity or transport at this point hundreds of years ago.
Enter carbon capture, which is short for carbon capture, utilization, and storage. This means grabbing carbon dioxide molecules, finding ways to use them once they're captured, and storing them safely. And there are lots of ways to do this.
Carbon capture really describes a host of technologies, ranging from the natural, having to do with forestry, for instance, or farming, all the way up to sci-fi technologies that involve somehow actually grabbing the CO2 out of the atmosphere and storing it somewhere. Trees are the most effective natural means of carbon capture we have, and they're actually absorbing quite a lot of CO2, becomes part of their mass, and that's another form of storage.
There's also the ocean.
The oceans are naturally a really important part of the overall climatic cycle because they absorb large amounts of carbon from the atmosphere.
But these natural solutions are hard to predict and control, in part because climate change is changing forests and oceans and how much carbon they can absorb. So scientists are also studying man-made technologies, like retrofitting factories and industrial plants in order to catch carbon as it burns. Some industrial sites already do this, but the technology isn't always reliable, and
you would need to increase that over 100-fold to begin to really make the kind of dent we need to do in carbon emissions for averting dangerous climate change.
Then there's the possibility of removing carbon that's already in the atmosphere. That's called direct air capture. It could help with carbon that's been around for hundreds of years, or help control diffuse sources of emissions from things like cars.
Direct air capture is really more like actually hitting the brake, and eventually, if we do it well enough, going backwards, actually going back towards the climate we had before climate change became an issue.
Here's the thing. No single technology will solve climate change.
We're going to need some version of all those technologies for this to work. We're likely to see increasing numbers of projects around carbon capture in the years ahead.
But today, there are two big obstacles for scaling carbon capture technologies.
One is technological. I mean, we still don't really know how to effectively grab carbon. We have pilot projects. We've had early attempts at industrial or even air capture. But to hit the scale we're talking about, that is just technological development of a totally different nature.
The second one, economic. Buying and using carbon capture technologies would be expensive, really expensive.
Unless you put some value on actually capturing the carbon, you're asking companies or individuals to pay a lot. At this point, you know, in the EU, you might have carbon prices that are in the $40, $50 range.
In the US, the Biden administration priced carbon at $51 per ton earlier this year, more than 7 times the Trump administration's price. That means U.S. companies that capture 100 tons of carbon could make $5,100 from it. But that's not enough for companies to invest more in carbon capture.
You probably need potentially double that. If you actually put a price on carbon, keep it high enough effectively, that makes it economically worthwhile for companies to invest more in trying to avert carbon emissions, actually capture them.
Almost every plan to combat climate change includes scaling carbon capture by 2050, but
it's really only been over the last 5-10 years, perhaps, that the sheer math of climate change has become so overwhelming that everyone recognizes that we do need to do this. We do need to catch up.
Here's what you should remember. Carbon capture refers to a whole host of solutions, and scaling many of them is essential to address climate change. But we need to learn more about scaling carbon capture, and companies need incentives to pay for it. And regardless of carbon capture, it's important to find sources of alternative energy.